Namaste. Welcome to Phenomenal Pentad.
Have you ever heard the story of Mayureshwar? Ganesha is the elephant-headed god of new beginnings, success, wisdom, and remover of obstacles. He is traditionally worshipped before any major enterprise. Various incarnations are related to the legends of Lord Ganesha killing various demons. According to the Ganesh Purana, Ganesha incarnated as Mayureshwar, who has six arms and a white complexion. His mount is a peacock. He was born to Shiva and Parvati in Treta Yuga for the purpose of killing the demons Hindu. It was predicted by Lord Brahma that Lord Ganesh would incarnate as Vinayak in the Krita Yuga, as Mayureshwar in Treta Yuga, as Gajanan in Dwapar Yuga, and as Dhumraketu in Kali Yuga.
Let me tell you the story of Lord Mayureshwar. There was a king named Chakrapani who ruled a city called Kandaki. He was a righteous king. He remained childless for many years. Though he did many pujas, yagnas and gave donations to beget a child, but remained fruitless. One day, Seth Sonaka arrived. He told them a way of fast for pleasing Lord Surya. The royal couple followed the procedure. Ugra conceived due to the power of a solar mantra, but was unable to bear the extreme heat radiating from it, so she abandoned it in the ocean. Soon, a son was born from this, with three eyes, a big head and an ugly body. The baby was returned by the ocean god to his grieving father, who named him Sindhu, the ocean. The child was very cruel, since from his childhood. As he grew up, he wanted to conquer the three worlds and become the ruler of the universe. He started a penance to please Lord Surya. After a severe penance, Lord Surya appeared before Sindhu. Sindhu asked for a boon of lack of death. Lord Surya granted it by handing him a bowl of nectar. He was asked to keep the bowl in his throat. If it were there, he would be invincible. If this were removed or destroyed, his death time would arrive.
Due to this power of his boon, he conquered the heaven and imprisoned the gods. He ordered people to worship him instead of the devas. Donations and sacrifices were stopped. The devas prayed to Lord Ganesh. Lord Ganesh in turn promised that he will incarnate to slay that Rakshasa. On the other hand, Parvati underwent austerities meditating on Mahaganapati, the supporter of the entire universe, for 12 years at Linyadri. Pleased by her penance, Mahaganapati blessed her by the boon that he would be born as her son. In due course, Mahaganapati was born to Parvati and was named as Gunesha by Shiva. He grew up in the guidance of Rishi Gautam and Devi Ahalya.
Little Ganesha once knocked an egg from a mango tree, from which appeared a peacock. As peacock was Ganesha's mount, he came to be known as Mayureshwar. Sindhu was given the everful bowl of Amrita, or elixir of life, as a boon from the sun god. Ganesha defeated Sindhu's army, cut his general Kamalasur into three pieces, and then Ganesha did Achamana with sacred water, and with his divine axe he hit Sindhu. By his blow, the bowl with nectar was destroyed, thus killing him. The creator Brahma is described as having built the Mogaon shrine and marrying Siddhi and Bodhi to Ganesha. At the end of this incarnation, Ganesha returned to his celestial abode, giving his peacock mount to his elder brother, Skanda, with whom the peacock mount is generally associated. Another legend says that this place was populated by peacocks, giving the village its Marathi name, Morgaon, which means the village of peacocks, and its presiding deity, the name Moreshwar. A Ganapatya legend recalls how Lord Brahma, the creator, the preserver god Vishnu, and the dissolver god Shiva, the divine mother Devi, and the sun god Surya meditated at Morgaon to learn about their creator and their purpose of existence. Ganesha appeared before them in the form of an Omkar flame and blessed them.
Another legend records that when Brahma created his son Kama, he himself became a victim of desire and lusted for his own daughter Saraswati. Upon invocation by all the deities, the sacred Turiya Tirtha river appeared and Brahma bathed in her waters to cleanse his sin of incest. Brahma then came to Murgaon to worship Ganesha, carrying water from the river in his water pot. Entering the Ganesha shrine, Brahma stumbled, and the water fell from his pot. When Brahma tried to pick it up, it was turned into the sacred Karha river that still flows there. From then onwards, Ganesha is being worshipped as Mayureshwar in Murgaon. Visiting Mayureshwar temple is the beginning and ending of Ashtavinayak Yatra.
Do participate in the quiz. Link in the description below.
Do not forget to like, share and subscribe to Phenomenal Pentad for more videos. Thanks for watching.